And we'll go right on continuing with hearing more about what's going to happen in Finland and later on about hear about the Dutch experience. Professor Olli Kangas is closely involved in what is happening and what will be happening in Finland. Please.
Thank you very much. Is it possible to get the PowerPoint presentation? Is it possible to get my PowerPoint presentation?
It will come.
Okay. Thank you for the invitation, and apologies that my presentation will not be that eloquent as Guy's presentation. He spoke that nicely about freedom, about justice, about everything, about hair, about stamina. I don't have that much to say about hair. And perhaps my presentation is more mundane when it comes to freedom and that kind of things. And when it comes to stamina, I'm a long-distance runner, done a couple of marathons also in this city, so that I hope that I have that stamina. This run I'm running just now has lasted 1 year, very precise 1 year. So that we began to run in the mid of September, or in the last part of September, we got the order from the Finnish government to start planning the pilot study. And hopefully there will come out something coming up. Okay. The government wanted to start this experiment because they thought that the social security system that we have just now in Finland is not corresponding to those changes that are taking place in the labor markets. Kai spoke about those changes, and we know everybody here what kind of changes are taking place. And then the other problem the government wanted to solve by basic income is different kind of disincentive that are built in the Finnish social security system. Because there are lots of income-tested benefits that are on top of each other, and then if the person is getting employment, in that case, those benefits are cut down by every single euro people is earning, and in that case, it means that it doesn't paid work at all in very many cases. And very often we have a situation that a person who is, let's say, single mother who has two kids, is living in Helsinki, has a rental house, gets unemployment benefit, etc. In that case, the social money she's getting is that much that she should get more than 2,400 euro in salary or wage in order to get more from employment than she's getting from the social security. Okay, is it possible to have that device where I can put forward, because there are lots of slides and I will not show everything. The experimental budget is 20 millions, and the government said that everything should begin in the beginning of 2017, and it meant that we had a very strong time pressure, so that it dealt not that much of stamina. It did well, so that I was not a runner of 10,000 meters of marathon, but I had to run 1 mile or so very rapidly. And that's one reason we ended up in that kind of plan as we ended up, as I will show to you a little bit later, show to you. And the government wanted us to experiment how to abolish those disincentives we have, so that the government didn't have all those fancy ideas and nice ideas as Guy spoke about, so that they were very mundane, and they wanted to see if it's possible to somehow make work pay in Finland. And somehow I had the feeling that it's a mission impossible and there should be somebody else than me. And they gave four models us to develop and evaluate. The first one was a full basic income that was more than 1,000 euros. And then we had lots of calculations, lots of microsimulations, and lots of evaluations. And then we decided that that is not our model. And also there were some political reasons, because the social democrats and trade unions hadn't accepted this kind of proposal at all. And then we thought that, okay, it's a political reality and we have to take it into consideration, and then we gave up that. And then negative income tax was one possibility. And the problem in Finland is that we by now don't have updated income register that's on the basis of on daily or weekly or monthly basis. It's only annual basis. And as Kai said, we should have given a lump sum for people. Instead of that, we thought that, okay, it's not possible for us for the time being. 2020, we will have that kind of register, and then it would be possible to do that kind of tricks with negative income tax. But the government wanted to start it by now, or very rapidly, and in the beginning of 2017. And then other models. It's a kind of participatory basic income where we pay a little sum and then some extra in the case that people will do some useful in society. But then we decided that it's very difficult for us to decide what is useful in our society and who defines what is useful and who inspects what people are doing and how much should we pay for this and that and that. And then finally, in the end of the day, we had partial income. And then we thought that, okay, we make calculations that the 550 is the smallest sum that we can propose. And then we make calculations up to 850. And then political realities. The dotted line here is a mark that the parties about that are positive in relation to basic income, and parties that are below the dotted line, they are against it. And the funny thing is that in the present government, we have only center party that's in favor. The Conservatives and True Finns are strongly against. So that it was a strange combination, because only in addition to center party, the Greens and the left-wing league are in favor, but other parties are against. And you can imagine which kind of political game and intrigues there were behind the curtains when we were proposing this, so that the support was coming for center party, but then the other parties in the government, they were a little bit reluctant or not that eager to go ahead in this question. So that I will write about that, but not as long as I'm running. But after this run, I will write a very interesting book about political decision making. The expert group that consisted of lots of economists and lots of social scientists and lawyers. We proposed that the whole adult population should be target for the experiment. And then we did some limitations on the basis of age and also on the basis of income, because our budget was limited. And then we thought that, okay, let's concentrate on low income people, because the effects work incentives that the government was most interested in are the strongest. And then we had that bad word randomization, national level randomization, that we thought that it will be represented for the whole country, and then there will be local experiments that take into account those local effects, as in some international or some experiments in other countries. And to increase the sample size, because we had a limited budget, 20 million, and it means that if we had taken persons that are not getting anything else from the social security system, in that case, the compensation or basic income should be taken from the running budget or the experiment or experimental budget. In that case, we should or could have something like 1,500 people in the experiment, and that's too much. And then the government, in its wisdom, decided that we can use those social security benefits that are already in payment to somehow be fake at the basic income. And then we thought that, okay, we could have almost 10,000 persons included in the sample. And we had fancy ideas that there would be different levels of basic income and then also different levels and different tax systems that are linked to those basic income systems. And then we could get comparative data on bad basic income and good basic income systems and then bad taxation systems and good taxation systems. And we did lots of power calculations, how much we should have this kind of persons or that kind of persons to get reliable results. But what happened in the end was that the basic income is 560 euros a month. It's net, and it corresponds to the basic level of unemployment, basic unemployment compensation. On top of that are coming other social security benefits like housing allowances, in some cases also social assistance benefits, etc., etc., child allowance, so that it's not replacing, it's replacing very many of those benefits that are called basic sickness benefit, basic unemployment compensation, basic rehabilitation, etc. And social benefits that, as I said, that the social benefits that exceed that level, they will be paid out as nowadays. And because it's a compulsory or obligatory participation, we should have a certificate that nobody will lose, because the Constitution will say that we can't do obligatory experiment in the case that somebody will be obliged to take a smaller sum of money as she or he is getting just now. And then we decided, or they decided, who made the law, so that perhaps 3,000 unemployed persons who are getting unemployment compensation from the social insurance institution are taken as an experimental group. And it's a random selection from like 150,000 unemployed people who are getting that basic benefit. And the rest are the kind of control group. And follow-up studies will be based on registers, interviews, and different kind of surveys. Now, why? We began to make a code, but it was not that fancy code suite that came out. There were constitutional constraints. First of all, equal treatment, and then all those fancy designs that we had on different levels were dropped out because it hadn't been worked. And also, those different levels had been very difficult to model in legislation because we had to write a law. Everything should be based on law. And then tax authorities were not involved in the writing of the law, therefore tax-free. And it's a lot of criticism that it's a tax-free income. But the political reality was that the Conservative Minister of Finance never ever gave order to the tax authorities to participate in this. And then tax authorities said that we will not participate unless the minister is giving order to participate. And therefore, tax-free. And only Kela employed, unemployed, it was easy to get a sample from there, and also it's a cheap sample. And we had a kind of, to my mind, a clever idea, background idea there, that we could then spare money for the real experiment that will hopefully start in 2018, and we can expand the target group to the whole, not only to unemployed persons, but the other things also. And time pressure was extremely strong, and then ICT system was unable, or with Kela, the social insurance system was unable to create ICT system to pay out. And the reactions on the bill were devastating, so that the Social Democrats, they were against us. They were against us already in the very beginning, and now they were extremely critical and also critical to me. So that how scientist who has some self-respect can ever propose that kind of silly thing. The Greens, who are in favor of basic income, they were furious. It's a deliberate falsification of basic income. The same with left-wing league. Christian Democrats wanted to have a universal credit system, the UK type. Centre Party criticized that the youth are not included, but they said that, okay, this is a start. It's a good start, and let's plan a better one. And the only guys who were somehow in favor of our experiment were economists. They, of course, criticized that it's not a cost neutral because taxation is not there, but they said that, okay, this is a very good start, and let's wait for it better. And what will happen next? The Minister of Social Affairs will write the bill that will be proposed to the government. Government will propose it to the parliament, and then parliament will discuss it. And it's very interesting to see what the Constitutional Committee will say about it. I have somehow managed to convince the Social Democrat leader or the Social Security Committee that she's in favor of this experiment. But let's see what will happen in her party group. But anyway, the Constitutional Committee is a very crucial one for the future of this experiment. And now it seems to be so that we can expand the sample by including some other groups, because we have lots of money, not lots of money, but let's say 14 millions left, and then the government has said that perhaps there will be something more, and then also some other institutions have said that perhaps they will contribute, so that we are hoping for getting something like 20 millions more. And the critics about the small sample, okay, it's very easy to expand in the case that we use the employed persons, so that we could have very easily 6,000, 7,000 unemployed persons, but it doesn't solve that problem, that it's a selective group of people. And then other groups, then unemployed or other groups that are getting social benefits, they are expensive for the running budget or the experiment, but in the case the tax system is involved and the tax collected on income that's coming on top of basic income is somehow returned to the experiment. In that case, we can expand the number of people further. And then there's a question, obligatory or voluntary participation, and also the question that how to deal with the local experiment. The problem with the involving a whole municipality in the experiment is that the municipalities in Finland are, not all of them are pretty big, but those municipalities where it's possible or clever to have that kind of experiment, they have something like more than 20,000 inhabitants. So that there must be some aerial or local experiments, not the municipal experiments. And let's see. So that the next step is that we will get some kind of verdict from the Constitutional Committee, and that's important in that sense that if Constitutional Committee says that it's not possible to make the kind of human experiments, in that case it's done, so that it's over. But let's hope that they will say that it's possible to do that, and then we will have something more in the beginning of 2018, and we have more time to plan the legislation, we have more time to plan ICT technology, we have more time to plan a better sample than we had now. So this is a kind of short survey of my running.
Thank you a lot, Olli Kangas. We have now the clear and simple definition of what is the basic income concept, what's the definition. Then we have the complex realities of the mission Almost Impossible, showing what bridge has to be built to solve this.